Hey everybody, Onepeg here with another newsy news. Update. So Sunday was actually an incredibly busy day for me, and I didn't realize that following the Twitch gaming interview that Nikita had, he ended up scooting right on over to Pestily's channel and did another interview with Pest to talk about things a little bit more in depth, albeit a bit more relaxed than it was sitting in front of like 100,000 people on a Twitch gaming channel. So because I didn't know that, I didn't end up reporting on it, but because I like to be relatively thorough, I figured it would be a good idea to at least do a summary on that information, maybe offer up my own little spin on it, show you guys some imagery for things that we know had come up in concept art stuff in the past and kind of go from there. Just really quickly before I get into that, I do want to say a very, very special thank you to my colleague, friend, and fellow content creator, Noise Guy, who has another YouTube channel that does content similar to mine. Noise has been collecting all of these old images and concept pieces for Tarkov for a while now and has graciously offered to share that stuff with me in a Google Drive that he had set up. So a lot of the images that I'm going to show you through the course of this that harken back to old images from when Nikita had teased these originally is because of the work that he has put in. So please go and give Noise a sub, follow him on Twitch, all that stuff. And Noise, thank you very much, man. That was really, really cool of you. Thank you very much. So a renowned Lord, Savior, and international sensation underwear model, Nikita, decided that he was going to join Pestily on his stream at the beginning of Pestily's stream to talk about all things related to 12.11 and beyond. The first thing up being, obviously, 12.11 changes. So we know that 12.11 brings along the factory expansion, the factory boss. Nikita didn't really have anything additional to give us about the factory boss, but he did say that it's almost done, and we should expect to see 12.11 by the end of this month. Now, that's a target. He didn't want to, I guess, adhere to a specific date because you never know, things come up and things get pushed back. But he did say that the factory expansion itself is relatively finished. They play tested it. Things seem like they're working good. They're polishing up 12.11 and making sure that the boss has like the right patrol waypoints and his behavior and AI setup is the way that they want it to be. And then it'll be all in our hands. He also said that for this patch, there's not going to be any Tarkov TV live. So we won't see a podcast from them talking about stuff and showing the gameplay and all the stuff that they had done with prior patches because they're just going to give it to us and be like, surprise! But we do know that there's going to be some things that have changed mechanically in the game, and there's also some new additions to 12.11 that Nikita talked about that we didn't prior to now know. One of them is that there's going to be some ballistics changes, specifically related to how those ballistics penetrate different surfaces in the game, like doors and walls and cardboard boxes, for instance, which are right now like bulletproof, and chain link fences, which have crazy amounts of refraction, and 995 for whatever reason just doesn't penetrate it at all, but 55A1 seems to go through it like butter. So we don't really have a reason to rhyme to how it works right now, but hopefully after 12.11 we'll be able to do a whole lot of testing and figure all of that out and see what works and what doesn't. Maybe we'll make up a new game show called like Will It Pen. Who knows? Along with that also comes the first iteration of weapon malfunctions, which is misfires. And this is also going to tie into a new durability system, which from what it sounds like, the durability system for the game is going to be something where weapons degrade a whole lot faster than what it was we had seen up until this point. Especially if you're using stuff like high penetration ammunition, which is notorious for tearing up things like gun barrels. We should see like 7N31 being shot through a crisp vector start really degrading that vector a whole lot faster. Hopefully way faster, because something like that should be tearing a gun up, especially in a video game where something like it could also be considered pretty overpowered and we could use some more expense. Now, this also is going to tie into a new durability modifier that's going to be given to certain types of attachments. Things like compensators and suppressors and dust covers, things like that are going to affect how fast a weapon degrades. So we could start seeing weapon builds that not only have some type of emphasis on ergo and recoil, but also on durability, which is an interesting thought, considering that the durability system is not only supposed to affect your accuracy, which it already does by making that cone of accuracy ever larger as the durability decreases, but also could throw off your point of impact specifically, meaning that where you aim may not have a center of impact associated with where you're aiming in that cone. It could actually move the entire cone, like the barrel's warping or something along those lines. And that's something that Nikita teased when he talked about Tarkov with the gun nuts, when Clean had him on. And lastly, we have an optics rework, and there were a couple of things that were teased with this, specifically related to this picture of the 155 Ultima and its associated thermal camera, which was said to be incredibly rare by Nikita inside of the game, which also means that we're getting the 155 Ultima in the game, which he also hadn't set up until this point, so that's kind of cool to have a space shotgun, but it probably won't be all that good. It's going to be kind of a meme, and the camera is only going to be found in Raid, which means that it's going to be super rare, which makes the meme even more so. Expensive memes are the best memes, who knows? And we also had this screen cap of this really crappy T12 thermal that has been teased many, many times before, and you can see quite clearly on the thermal imagery how this is going to look like an Atari game. But hey, I mean, thermals are thermals, right, boys? Right. Now on to Streets. In the past, a long, long time ago, there was the talk of Streets of Tarkov coming out at some point. During those conversations, there was this car dealership boss that had been teased. Not that he works at the car dealership, but that the car dealership is kind of like the base of operations. Nikita said that the car dealership is going to be kind of like the center inside of Streets of Tarkov for all scav operations in Tarkov, which means that the boss of Tarkov is going to be a beefy, beefy boy. In this case, I think that the boss associated with this is going to be this guy or something similar to this guy, because Nikita said that he's going to be a big guy with a machine gun, which I also would be led to believe means that he could end up having this belt-fed backpack for a magazine, which would be also very, very interesting. Now, Nikita also went on to say that this car dealership is going to be one of those, like, nearly impenetrable forces kind of deals, where there's going to be snipers set up, there's going to be fixed weapons, there's going to be mines and all kinds of other stuff to keep you from being able to get in here. So attacking this, according to Nikita, would be like wanting to commit suicide via scav boss. Whether or not that actually ends up happening, we'll have to see in terms of like if we actually get our hands on this at any point in time in the near future, which it doesn't look like we're going to, by the way. But this boss, Nikita said, also looks like he's going to make some patrols outside of the actual location where this fortress is located, so you could ambush him as he patrols away. He also said during this interview that there could be the chance that on Streets, we could see scav bosses from other maps end up visiting Streets. So for instance, we know that Rishala ends up using police officers from the city of Tarkov as his guards. But it's also possible that there's a police station, which we know that there is actually on Streets, because Nikita talked about there being a police station that's just about ready right now on Streets. And since Rishala is known for having corrupt police as guards, what's to say that Rishala couldn't show up at the police station on Streets? But that would be a really cool event, right? To suddenly see Rishala showing up on Streets? Now, the reason why this is so interesting to me is because Nikita went on to say that Streets of Tarkov is supposedly so large that it could be its own game. It's larger in size, once it's fully implemented, I guess, than all of the other maps in Tarkov combined, in terms of, I guess, square meters or kilometers, which means that we're going to need some really dynamic spawning and despawning of certain entities, like scavs, depending on where people are on the map, which also means that the Streets of Tarkov is going to be a pretty involved project. That also means that what I said originally when Streets of Tarkov was being discussed with Nikita toward the beginning of the year, and Nikita saying that he was hoping that Tarkov's Streets map was going to be released by the end of the year, was most likely not going to be the case, ended up being confirmed during the Pestily interview. He said it's pretty likely that Streets will not happen this year. What did I tell you? But that's okay, because I'd rather see him get it right, especially when you have stuff like the BTR. Now, we saw the BTR many, many, many times, and Nikita actually elaborated on the BTR itself and said that there's going to be two, maybe even three types of BTRs. The first one being the BTR-80 that we saw in the trailer that had the 30mm cannon that would use like OFZ shells, for instance. He said that you're not going to be able to drive it, but you have two options. You could tell the BTR to go to a certain location and light that location up with a bunch of fire, or you could use that as a taxi to take you to a different place on the map as long as you had the rubles to pay for those services. The second option would be a BTR-80 that shows up that doesn't have a gun at all. It's just the personnel carrier with no mounted placements. And then the third, he said, could be a BTR on tracks, which also would have larger payloads, more weaponry, and larger amounts of ammo. So it could be something that could lay down even more fire onto a certain area, depending on where you wanted to send it and how aggressive you wanted it to be, and obviously would then be more expensive because it could also have a larger crew. Now, that also ties back into the trailer, because originally, I was looking at this going, okay, so the BTR being a taxi means that all of those guys hopping off of the BTR were PMCs, right? Because it's a taxi. Well, maybe not necessarily true. In this case, you can also choose to have it go to a place and light that area up. And Nikita talked about the crew associated with those BTRs. So it's very possible also that there is a scav team that sits on the BTR or raider team or whatever you want to call it. When you send it off to a certain area, those raiders riding on the BTR, hopping off, could actually be AI that's now working for you because you hired them as mercenaries to go out and wreck shit, which also is super fucking cool, man. Now, from here, we talked about countering it, and Nikita went on to say that, yes, again, the RPG is going to be implemented in the game. We're going to see the RPG 7, and it's going to have different payloads, maybe even incendiaries. So we'll have to see what Nikita ultimately ends up settling on with the RPG, but that probably also means that we'll see fixed placement rocket-propelled grenades. So, who knows? Who knows? Now, in terms of where Streets is right now, Nikita said that Streets is playable for the areas that they have completed, but they still have to do things like placing loot and spawning in AI and despawning AI when people are too far away from it because of the size of the map and because they don't want the servers to crash and burn on themselves. They also need to work on like visual optimizations, and Unity 2019 has to get implemented. In terms of things like Unity 2019, Reflex, NVIDIA Reflex, and DLSS, Reflex, he said, is coming really soon. DLSS was supposed to be a secret, but he ended up leaking it unknowingly, not knowing that he was supposed to keep it a secret. But DLSS is being worked on. He didn't give a word as to when, and I guess it's something that we're just kind of supposed to forget about until they get that done. And then insofar as Unity 2019 is concerned, here's kind of like the timeline. So 12.11 is supposed to go live by the end of this month. Unity 2019 is supposed to go live 2 weeks after 12.11 goes live on the ETS servers. So on the early test servers, we're supposed to see Unity 2019 implementation, which also gives us the ability to test things like inertia, which is also supposed to be something that gets played around with. We're also supposed to be able to test things like VoIP, which is supposed to be live in 12.12. So there's supposed to be a whole bunch of stuff that gets implemented on ETS 2 weeks after this 12.11 patch goes live for all of us that have ETS access to be able to play with and then give feedback to the devs on. So I would say that if you do not have ETS access, you might want to sign up for it if it's something that you want to play with and test out and see what you like. And if you do have ETS access, you should definitely participate and give them that feedback because they use it. Then on to Lighthouse. So Lighthouse was teased as something that Nikita wanted to have released by the end of summer. And again, I kind of raised an eyebrow to that, thinking like, okay, look, maybe that's not really going to happen because you're just in the gray box phase. And two podcasts ago, you were signing off on gray boxes being done after the podcast was over. And I thought that that was kind of like a really short timeline. He said that he pulled about 70% of the staff that was originally working on Streets to try and push that out for the end of the year on over to Lighthouse because we want content and we want things to be able to play on new stuff. It does not sound like at this point he's still sticking with the narrative of having it done by summer. He never mentioned anything about summer at all. And he said that he wanted Lighthouse completed for this year. So maybe we're not seeing it until like September, October. You know what I'm saying? But that's okay. And he also said that they're in the process of hiring even more people to work on this stuff. He was up to like 130 devs. So hopefully they'll be up to 200 devs. Who knows? And then finally, Nikita ended up teasing this thing about something coming up next week. Didn't sound like it was in the next week, but next week. So I would say something around like the week of the 20th, the 21st of this month. And if I was going to guess, I would say that it's likely going to be something having to do with a free labs entry. So hopefully it doesn't end up sticking around for too god-awful long. I'm still like kind of cool about it. I'm looking forward to playing something, doing some things that are a little bit different. Give me the old Legland Express. We'll get in there, do a little bit of kneecapping. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, guys, thank you very much for taking the time to check out this little video, and I will see you in the next one. I'll see you on stream, and yeah, peace.